Hello, I'm Farid from Route 77 Harley Davidson Kuala Lumpur. So today this is the Pan Am, the new 2021 model adventure touring by Harley Davidson. It's meant for off-road and on-road.
Hi, saya Hilman daripada Harley Davidson of Petaling Jaya. Hari ini kita nak bincangkan aksesori pasal part nama mereka. Sebarang pertanyaan boleh komen di bawah. Let's go. Hari ini kita nak tunjuk windshield aksesori part nama mereka yang Harley Davidson ada keluarkan. Okay. Windshield seperti yang anda lihat sekarang ni adalah windshield 11 inci Adventure. So means it's an accessory. It's not original. It's not original equipment lah. Okay, original equipment 4.5 jauh lebih tinggi dibanding dengan apa Adventure 11 inci hitam ni lah. Okay, dan walaupun anda dah tukar windshield, the mechanism untuk naik dan turun takkan ada masalah, masih sama. Untuk aksesori kedua yang Harley Davidson keluarkan untuk windshield part nama mereka, kita ada windshield Adventure 18 inci clear. Untuk 18 inci windshield clear khas untuk rider yang tidak suka rintangan angin terlalu kuat.
Next, we got the headlight grills. This come with the black powder coated finish. These grills function to protect your headlight from rock and debris without reducing your headlight visibility.
We also have a mesh radiator shield that attaches to the front of the radiator to protect it from small stones and other debris, especially when riding off-road.
This is the skid plate we installed here for this Pan America. Come with the heavier aluminium material. Okay. Function of these skid plates to protect from stone or any obstacle that you are having during the off-road riding. Okay. And it protects more area compared to stock original equipment.
Okay, untuk accessory comfort Pan America, Harley Davidson ada keluarkan dua seat accessory. Pertama, seperti anda lihat sekarang, seat yang kita telah tukarkan ni adalah seat Reach Solo Seat. Reach Solo Seat untuk comparekan dengan original equipment, 1 inci lebih rendah. Dan ianya membuat rider lebih confident dekat stopping. 4 special Pan America, dia telah datang dengan adaptive monoshock. So apabila datang dengan adaptive monoshock, you install the Reach Seat, anda akan rasa lebih confident. Untuk seat kedua yang Pan America Harley Davidson keluarkan adalah Tall Boy Seat, khas untuk rider yang tinggi yang nak lebih rasa selesa duduk atas motor. Tall Boy Seat to compare dengan original equipment, 1 inci jauh lebih tinggi dan lean for ankle dan knee jauh lebih besar.
So here come for another interesting parts, which is the box or luggage. What we have installed here is the aluminium box. And this is the collaboration with the SW Motec, and it's been engineered, tested for its perfectly fit, durability and reliability. This box also comes with the two finish. One is the black finish, another one is the another silver. Alright, next is we got the side case here. As you can see, there's a seal lid here to protect from water entrance. Okay, so we're talking about the luggage capacity. So for the right side, we cover around the 37 liters, and the left side 45 liters, and for the top box, we cover for the 45 liters. And each box can carry up to 10 kg for each. So means that you got the 30 kg in total when you go off riding.
So, I'm going to demo how to remove this box to the side case. Okay, first, you just tuck in your key and then pull over and then just set it up. Simple as that.
This box is called a sport luggage case and it comes with the silver color. This luggage set is designed primarily for on-road use by riders looking for the utility of luggage, but who also value a clean looks when the luggage is removed. The side case and the top case are designed for installation and removal, and each luggage piece has an integrated handle to enable it to be carried off the bike. Luggage volume capacity for the right case is 36 liters, left case is 40 liters, top case is 40 liters. We also have the tank bag. It is a water-resistant rain cover and has a matching touch-sensitive window. It is convenient for riders to keep their small items for easy access. This bag has a volume capacity of 8 liters and up to 2 kg weight.
Untuk bag ni, kita ada first compartment clear belah atas dan anda boleh letak power bank di bawah, then you can direct charging lah. Okay, on the side, kita ada small pocket and we have the big pocket on the center. Untuk ikat strap di bawah, kita akan ikat direct bawah seat. Untuk kat depan, dia telah bagi compartment untuk kita direct ikat kiri dan kanan. Untuk Screaming Eagle Performance, Pan America, Harley Davidson telah keluarkan dua item. Seperti yang anda lihat di belakang saya, kita ada titanium exhaust, stainless steel mid-pipe, titanium body dengan carbon and cat tip. Okay, exhaust ni, kalau anda tengok, the design is much more better from the original equipment. Dan exhaust ini 42% jauh lebih ringan berbanding dengan original equipment. Dan exhaust Screaming Eagle Titanium ni, anda akan dapat deep sound, bass and not too extreme. Mari kita dengarkan. Untuk item kedua, performance part, Pan America Harley Davidson telah keluarkan High Flow Activated 9% more intake to the engine, dan air filter ini is washable. Maksudnya, apabila ada service, less cost for you to change the air filter. So service side akan hanya basuh dan akan pakaikan balik performance air filter itu. Dan air filter ini harus digabungkan dengan performance chemical marker.
Okay, here's come another interesting parts for this new Pan America special. We call it as the forward auxiliary light. As you know, when we go off-road riding, we don't have the street light. So we need a better light to clear our road. So this light function, there's a three function in same light. First is fog light, second is the driving light, third is off-road light. And it covers 275 meters forward visibility and 50 meters side. So it's very useful and helpful when you go off-road riding, especially at night.
The factory integrated design makes these lights easy to install and a perfect fit and look on the bike.
Untuk Pan American Tires, Harley Davidson ada keluarkan dua item. Yang first, seperti anda lihat, original equipment dekat motor, mereka menggunakan Michelin Scorcher Adventure depan belakang. This one more to town riding lah. Okay, for those who want to go for the off-road riding, Harley Davidson ada keluarkan Michelin Anarchy Wild Off-Road. Okay, nak compare dengan track Scorcher, off-road Anarchy jauh lebih beza, khas untuk off-road. Dan untuk halangan yang lembut dan any condition, anda boleh menggunakan Michelin Anarchy Off-Road.
The Anarchy tyre also offer excellent longevity and is resistant to high temperatures due to optimized tread depth.
Thanks for watching. I'm Farid from Route 77 Harley Davidson Kuala Lumpur. I hope that you gain knowledge from the video and enjoy the video. See you soon. Bye.
Hai, terima kasih kerana saksikan Pan America. aksesori hari ini. Saya Hilman daripada Harley Davidson of Putrajaya Gaya. Stay tuned untuk dapatkan service info up next. Dan sebarang pertanyaan anda boleh komen di bawah.
This powertrain is a home run for us. This bike guy has a top speed of 135 miles an hour with cargo. Crazy confident on the road. Carves switchbacks like a full-fledged street bike.
From a dynamic standpoint, the weight needs to be low and it needs to be in the right places. We spent a lot of time and effort to make sure that the bike really did everything.
Hai, saya Airi daripada Harley Davidson of Kuala Lumpur.
Dan saya Fikri dari Harley Davidson of Petaling Jaya.
Okey, hari ini anda bersama kami di Harley Davidson of Kuala Lumpur. Okey, kami akan menerangkan tentang service interval dan sedikit penjagaan yang anda sendiri boleh lakukan di rumah bagi model Pan America.
This is Pan America model owner manual. So, on every purchase of Pan America model, you're going to receive this owner's manual to know about basic maintenance of your bike. So inside that, there is a service report and also the service maintenance schedule that you can see at, on the screen now. So on every service component or checking point, there is a specific mileage on it to be performed. So all these things must be performed at authorized dealership. Right?
Okay. On every service visit, dealership will make sure your bike service check and be at a good and optimum condition. But you as owner must know what to check and also prepare before any of your ride.
Okay, as an owner, benda first kali yang kita boleh buat ialah check brake fluid reservoir untuk bahagian hadapan, dan di sini brake fluid reservoir untuk bahagian belakang. Okay, minyak yang digunakan adalah jenis dot 4 untuk bahagian depan dan belakang, dan kita perlu memastikan brake fluid level mencukupi. Pada brake fluid reservoir terdapat indikator menunjukkan maksimum dan minimum. Jadi anda perlu memastikan brake fluid dalam keadaan maksimum dan bukan minimum.
Besides checking the fluid level at the reservoir, at every service, we also will do the fluid contamination with water. There's a tools to measure water contamination inside the fluid. And also, the brake flushing is needed every 2 years as per recommended by the motor company. And also, why this is very important? Because when the fluid mix with water too high, it will cause the boiling point for the fluid very low, and it may affect to the brake failure at high temperature and also at high extreme riding condition. That is very important as brake is one of the main factor for the safety of the bike.
Okay, seperti yang kita bincangkan sebentar tadi, jika terdapat kekurangan pada brake fluid pada reservoir, kita perlu memastikan brake line dalam keadaan baik. Jika brake line dalam keadaan baik, kita perlu memastikan brake pad juga dalam keadaan baik. Okey, bagaimana kita memastikan brake pad dalam keadaan baik? Ialah kita memeriksa pada wear groove indicator yang telah disediakan pada brake pad itu sendiri. Okey. Jika wear groove indicator masih kelihatan, bermaksud brake pad masih selamat untuk digunakan. Okey. Anda jangan risau. Setiap kali anda menghantar motor ke authorized service di setiap dealership yang ada, technician akan memastikan thickness pada brake pad itu selamat untuk digunakan sehingga next untuk service. Pada bahagian wheels, kita perlu memastikan spoke dalam keadaan baik, tiada berkarat dan tiada longgar. Okey, seterusnya pada bahagian tayar, kita perlu memastikan tayar pressure mencukupi, iaitu 36 pada bahagian depan dan 42 psi pada bahagian belakang. Okey. Dua kaedah bagi memastikan tayar pressure mencukupi ialah bagi model special, kita boleh lihat pada instrument module, dan bagi model standard, kita memerlukan manual tire pressure gauge yang boleh dapati di PNA kami. Okay, mari saya tunjukkan macam mana untuk check tire pressure bahagian hadapan. Okay, firstly kita perlu buka cap for the tyre bar. Lebih mudah jika kita dapatkan extension untuk tyre pressure gauge. Just plug in dia. Dan sambungkan terus pada tyre pressure gauge. Okay, di sini kita dapat bacaan yang kurang untuk bahagian hadapan, dan kita perlu menambah tekanan udara pada bahagian hadapan. Bagi meriksa tyre pressure untuk model Pan America Special, kita boleh lihat pada paparan instrumen model. Okay. Kita perlu masuk ke menu dan pilih kepada bike status, dan di situ kita directly boleh lihat front tyre pressure 33 PSI dan rear tyre pressure ialah 39 PSI.
On every service visit, tyre is one of the checklist that we are going to check. There's a few things that we need to check on the tyre, especially tyre pressure and also the tread depth. So, let me show how we do at the dealership.
As we can see here at the tyre, there is a wear indicator mark, so we can check the tyre tread depth by visual. Beside that, we also can use this tyre tread depth gauge where we measure the tread. Let me show how we do it. As we can see, the tread depth is at the green zone. So if the tread goes to yellow zone, so we need to be standby, and if it goes to red zone, then we need to replace the tyre.
Kita perlu memastikan tyre tread dalam keadaan baik kerana tyre adalah salah satu medium yang direct contact dengan road condition. So, jika terdapat kausan pada tyre tread, dia akan mengurangkan kontak tyre dan juga road condition lah. Jadi, terutama jika dalam keadaan basah, dia akan mengurangkan traction dan boleh menyebabkan fatal injury. Okay, pada bahagian hadapan terdapat radiator dan juga coolant reservoir tank. Okay, kita perlu memastikan radiator dalam keadaan bersih tanpa ada halangan yang menghalang udara untuk menyejukkan enjin. Okay, untuk meriksa coolant level, kita perlu tanggalkan dipstick pada reservoir tank dan meriksa kandungan coolant yang terdapat dalam reservoir tank. Sebelum meriksa kandungan coolant pada reservoir tank, anda perlu memastikan enjin dalam keadaan sejuk bagi mengelak kecederaan melecur. Okay. Anda just perlu cabut dipstick dan meriksa kandungan coolant pada reservoir tank dipstick. Anda perlu memastikan keadaan coolant pada kadar maksimum dan bukan minimum.
For the engine oil, Harley has introduced the new oil to be used on this Revolution Mag engine. The oil is synthetic blend and also graded at 50W50. Beside that, the old Simply oil, which is 20W50, also can be used to this engine together with the mineral based 50W50. But to engine perform at its peak performance, please use the recommended oil which is just been introduced for the engine to perform at the max.
Just untuk melihat lubricant oil pada engine. Okay, sebelum memulakan proses ni, kita perlu memastikan engine dalam keadaan panas. Bagaimana memastikan keadaan panas? Kita perlu start pada idle selama 10 minit atau kita buat short ride dalam masa 2 minit. Dah mencukupilah. So, kita boleh letakkan motor pada keadaan upright macam ni atau pada keadaan DV stand. Okay, setelah enjin dimatikan, kita perlu menanggalkan dipstick pada bahagian enjin untuk memastikan minyak enjin dalam keadaan mencukupi. Untuk pertama sekali, kita perlu lapkan dulu kerana terdapat lebihan minyak ketika enjin dihidupkan sebentar tadi. Dan kita perlu masukkan semula, masukkan penuh dan kita tanggalkan dan lihat keadaan sebenar kandungan minyak enjin pada enjin. So di sini kita boleh lihat ada bahagian side stand dan juga bahagian upright. So jika keadaan motor pada bahagian upright, so kita perlu meriksa pada bahagian upright lah. So di sini menunjukkan minyak enjin dalam keadaan yang mencukupi.
Compared to the others Harley Davidson model, Pan America is using a chain drive. Why chain drive? Because as we know, Pan America is designed for off-road and also for off-road condition. Chain drive is more reliable, more suitable for the off-road condition as well as a road condition. So chain drive is required a special maintenance. As we know, the previous belt drive does not require any lubrication, but for a chain drive is required a lubrication to lubricate the o-ring inside the joint. And also the maintenance of chain is very important, especially the chain tension. If it's too loose, it will affect the sprocket to wear more faster. So that's why you must check it regularly. You can check it at the authorized service dealer.
Pada paparan instrumen modul ini juga, kita boleh lihat battery voltage yang terdapat pada motor sekali ini. Okay. Sama macam tadi, kita dah masuk dalam menu daripada bike status. Dan situ kita dapat lihat battery voltage pada 12 volt. Jika battery dalam keadaan baik, kita perlu memastikan voltage pada kadar 12.7 volt. Untuk itu, bateri motor sekali ini disediakan dengan charger port yang boleh disambung terus kepada bateri tender. Ia akan memanjangkan hayat bateri jika dijaga dengan rapi. Okay. Terima kasih kerana bersama kami dalam penerangan ringkas tentang service interval dan juga cara penjagaan yang mudah yang anda sendiri boleh lakukan di rumah bagi memastikan Pan America anda dalam keadaan yang baik untuk ditunggang.
Okay, as we mentioned earlier, service maintenance is very important for the bike. It's important to keep the bike at optimum performance. So please visit your local nearest dealership for the service maintenance. It starts from RM350 for all Malaysian network. And also the bike came with two years international warranty and it covers worldwide. So while you are traveling, if you have any complication with your bike, you can visit the nearest dealership to get it fixed. If you required further assistance, please contact your nearest dealership.
Thank you for tuning with us for today's shop talk.
We hope you guys enjoy it and also got an information about the service maintenance and also bike care.
Okay, don't forget to tune in with us for the next shop talk on 20th June 2021. And bye.